everybody.
Hi.
How y'all doing?
Hi. Welcome to Tired Tuesdays.
Welcome to Tired Tuesdays.
Oh my God, so much can happen in a week. So much has happened in a week. And today is officially the tiredest of Tuesdays. My name is A Natural.
My name is Lenny Harold, and you are now watching Tired Tuesdays.
Like,
what's up, Waffle?
So much has happened.
Yeah, so much. It's absolutely just ridiculous.
Can we start from last week's episode? We'll start positive.
Yeah.
Last week was our unexpectedly different and unplanned Tired Tuesdays talent show.
Mm-hmm.
Where we had a winner by default, even though she still came and sang all the notes and she performed down.
Yeah.
Congratulations to Seychelle Elise. Yeah. I said her name all crazy with the S's. Seychelle Elise. She is our second season winner. So she follows behind our last season's winner, Farrah Roche. Shout out to her. Thank you, Seychelle, for doing what you were supposed to do.
Okay.
And following the instructions and going out and getting your blessing like you should have.
Okay.
But also on Tuesday, we also did that virtually because both of us began feeling sick.
Yeah. And to be on the safe side, we were just like, okay, let's just, just in case. I had got tested last Sunday for COVID and I was like, and it came up negative. So I was like, okay, so we should be cool, but let's just to be on the safe side, let's just make sure that we're in separate areas.
Right.
Then Nat goes and get tested.
And it was positive for COVID.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm like, damn it. Right. I have too many things to do. And that was the only thing I thought about. I didn't care about health. I didn't care about going to sleep. I just was like, I'm in the middle of one of the busiest periods of my life. I don't need this. But it's very telling how sometimes God is like, sat down.
Yeah.
So I sat down.
Yep. And then I go and get tested Sunday, because I was like, I just feel like I have it. I want it, but I just feel like I have it. And I went and got tested on Sunday and it came back positive. So now I'm just like, and the sluggishness is real.
It is real. And I will say, I don't wish this on nobody. I do thank God that neither one of us are hospitalized, that it's not at that point. And I continue to believe God that it won't get to that point.
Amen.
Today is my halfway point for my symptoms. So this is my 7th day of quarantine. And I have 7 more days to go. And I'm believing God that at the end of that 7 days, I'm going to test and be negative.
Right.
And what's so funny about this is we were talking about, our own thoughts about COVID and the fact that we ain't get it this whole entire time since it started last year. And, is it real? Is it this? Is it that? Are we going to get vaccinated? And we were talking kind of slick. And then Rona was like, oh, I got something for you. Keep my name out your mouth. So
for real, she definitely clipped this up.
Like, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry for talking about you. I'm so sorry.
Exactly.
But yeah, so that's what's been going on. And surprisingly enough, like, I know I'm supposed to have sat down, but there were so many things that we needed to still do. Whether it was for Natural City Music, whether it was for Up We Go, and just work in general, I was still mixing somebody's album during that week. I had to do some work for Doja Cat's performance at the Billboard Awards on Sunday. There was just so much work that had to get done. And I'm like, oh my God, can I do this?
Right.
And I found ways to do it
without,
over-exaggerating and overextending myself. But I'm the kind of person, I'm a Virgo. Things have to get done regardless.
Yeah. I still don't know where he pulls the strength out to do certain things. It amazes the hell out of me. And even last week, coming into this week, I've had major editing that I've had to do for my job and just like, it's been massive and I still have a lot to do. So I've been doing it just kind of like in between of just like, resting
sleep.
For like 2 to 3 hours getting up and doing it, and just, yeah, it's just been crazy.
So yeah. Even though, you know, they are opening up outside, telling everybody you ain't got to wear your mask, stay far away from me.
Yeah, just use wisdom.
Just like, use wisdom.
Wear your mask if you feel like you need to.
Yeah, because it's real out here, and I didn't realize how real it was until I got sick.
Yeah.
So, and if you're vaccinated, great. But also make sure that you are taking the proper precautions as well. Mm-hmm. We were both very careful to contact anybody that we had been around to make sure that they didn't have any symptoms. And so far, everybody's good. And so that's basically it. And then I told him earlier today, I was like, we too close. Right. We too close. I don't want to share nothing else with him.
Right.
like if we done shared everything. And this was not one of the things that I ever wanted to share with you. Right. You are my best friend.
Exactly.
But this is disrespectful.
This is ridiculous.
Okay. So I'm done. And we need breaks from each other. And the thing about it is, the timing of it kind of worked out because our season finale is next week anyway.
Yeah.
So we were going to be taking a break. I had already planned on going on vacation after this. So, we're going to take that break. But I just didn't. Not like this.
Yeah.
Not like this.
Not like this.
Oh, my God.
You sound like a whole slave when you said.
Listen, that's how I feel. Let me tell you something. Yesterday and this morning, when I woke up, I felt like somebody hit me with a ton of bricks.
Yeah.
And this morning, I'm not going to go into too much detail, mm-hmm. but I do feel like I blacked out for like a good 20 minutes, just randomly.
Yeah.
But what's funny is after I woke up and came to myself, I felt a lot better.
See, and sometimes that's what we need. It's just to like lay down for a second.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But we still have a really good show for you guys today. We are welcoming a very special guest that is going to be on in just a few minutes by the name of Lauren Ashley. I cannot wait for you guys to meet her if you haven't already met her. And then also I want to say hi to people that are watching us on YouTube as well as Facebook. Last week we decided to add in the Facebook platform for the Tired Tuesdays talent show. And you guys showed us a lot of love on Facebook. We decided to do it again this week.
Yep.
So thank you for tuning in. And we have a few hot topics that we can get to, amen? I think we have a couple.
Let's go in.
Let's do some hot topics.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm just going to start roasting it. Now, the higher you are, the slower it'll roast. The closer you are, the faster it'll roast.
Need to see the end of the video.
That is the end of the video. Like, she doesn't do nothing else but roast it over the electric stove. So, a mess. So, let's start with SZA. And I thought this was really interesting, and I literally just sent this to Lenny before we started. So SZA posted a tweet today saying that she was asked to do a photo shoot for a magazine,
mm-hmm.
and she asked if she would be able to choose a black photographer, and the magazine said no.
Yeah.
So she politely declined their photo shoot and also made a point to say that, you know, it's 2021.
Mm-hmm.
You would think y'all would be doing better at this point, but...
Yeah, but we back into business as usual.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I guess the fad is over of, you know, considering black creatives. So, but proud of her for saying, all right, you guys missed an opportunity. You wanted me. I'm not going to be on your cover because all I'm asking for is a black photographer. And you're not going to do that. So there you go. You missed out. So,
you know,
hand clap to her.
I'm proud of her for making that decision and making that stand.
Yeah.
It's so disheartening that we're still dealing with that stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I remember, I think it was a couple of years back, it was like Gabrielle Union and a whole bunch of other different actors and actresses were talking about how when they go to movie sets, they normally have white hairstylists, white makeup artists, and none of them know how to do black hair or black makeup.
Right.
And it's almost like, why is that not a requirement? When you hire somebody for the job, like, make sure that either you hire black stylists or that your stylists are trained to do black hair and makeup.
Right.
And the fact that a lot of the stylists won't even train to do black hair and makeup is a form of racism.
Yeah.
Because when you go to beauty school, you're trained to do white hair.
Yeah.
Regardless of your ethnicity,
mm-hmm.
you're trained to do Becky's hair and you're trained to do Gertrude's hair.
Yeah.
But we need to be able to do Shamika's hair.
Yeah.
And give Raekwon a fade.
Like, right. This is very important.
You know? Yeah. And then, you know, it's also kind of bothersome because we are 1 year out from the death of George Floyd today.
Right.
And on the anniversary of his death, a lot of people are asking, did we do enough to make some changes? And I want to say that we did do a lot,
mm-hmm.
but the results of those actions are still yet to be seen. And like you said, it feels like, you know, some of the magic wore off because it almost seems like we're right back to the same bullshit.
Yeah.
You know?
And that was really the fear. I mean, we're coming up again. We're coming upon Juneteenth soon, so it's just kind of like, you know what I mean. What are we going to do for that? Like, how is the? I don't know. Like, what's going to happen?
Yeah.
You know, it's just and that was the fear factor of everything. Was, you know, was this whole thing just a fad? Where, you know, was the fight going to continue? And I believe that the fight is continued, but I just feel like there's still the power that be that, you know, is still making decisions.
And I kind of don't want to, I know it makes sense, but I don't necessarily want to hear the whole thing of, well, black people got to start supporting black businesses and, you know, take our money out of the other communities and put them back into our own. Like, yes, we know that that's going to work, but our basic daily needs are still provided by the powers that be.
Yeah.
And until there are affordable alternatives to those things that are distributed on a widespread base.
Yeah.
You know, expecting people in the inner city who only got dollars to their name to now spend tens and twenties of dollars to buy a black-owned product, it would be wonderful. But that's not the only thing we can do. So now I think I just want to hear some other solutions where it's something that everybody can do.
Right.
And it's not something that is so taxing on different people. I just need white people to get it.
Yeah.
Like, we gave y'all a year. Get it.
We still don't have enough black castings yet. Like, you know what I mean? There's like, it's still like, I've recently watched a few television shows where I'm just like, oh, so we still just going off with the one black character in the whole white folks crew, huh? Like, like, we still not going to at least do two? Like, you
right,
know,
can we at least get two black leads?
Right. And it's
that have lines?
Right.
You know.
Right.
So, but, you know, it is what it is. I mean, there's a lot of things that have happened in the world since then that, of course, you know, take people's focus. We know that the 24-hour news cycle is very short. And we did dominate most of the news cycle last year with you know, the Black Lives Matter protests and all that kind of stuff. I'm not saying that it's time to focus on someone else. We should be able to focus on all at the same time without, you know, losing anybody by the wayside. So,
And there has been some progresses. So,
yes.
You know what I mean? And just in the action of SZA saying, okay, well, you lost your opportunity to have me on the cover of your magazine. That's a victory because that's letting people understand where she stands and what she's going to stand for and what she won't stand for. You know what I mean?
Right.
Simple request.
And
as long as we keep doing that, we'll be fine.
And I would like her to name names.
I really want to know the name.
I want to know what the magazine was, and I want to know who told her no.
Yeah.
And I need them to be dragged for filth.
Yeah.
Because.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, come on.
Because if it was Beyonce, would they have still said no?
Well, see, this is the thing about Beyonce, because she did do that for, I think it was, the Elle magazine thing where she was coming out the helicopter?
Yeah.
And she specifically chose a black photographer.
Yeah.
You're not going to tell Beyonce no.
Right.
And I'm not saying that SZA has to be Beyonce, but it's not like SZA ain't nobody. You know what I mean? Like, SZA is SZA.
And if that's the request, like, what's the problem with requesting that? You know
exactly.
What I mean? The only thing that I can think of was that they already had a contract with the photographer. They did that prior, you know what I mean, to agreeing. And, you know, and that's what it is. But at the same time, you probably shouldn't lock in the photographer.
I was going to say, why would you do that? Yeah.
You know?
If the artist isn't comfortable with the photographer, you're not going to get a good photo shoot.
Right. Hello.
So...
So
it is what it is. Okay. I don't have any other hot topics. Wait. Oh, Versus Battle is coming back on May 30th, and the rematch that they were talking about.
Yeah, who's the rematch?
I'm a little disappointed. It's Timberland versus Swizz.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah. And I guess they wanted their moment to shine, like everybody's been shining with these, you know, big sets and all that kind of stuff. And I'm sure Swizz is going to bring out Alicia or whoever else has been on his beats. And Timberland's probably going to bring out Missy. And
it should be Timberland and Pharrell. Why can't we get this matchup? This is such a missed opportunity. Like, does Pharrell just not want to do it? And that's why, you know what I mean? Like, do we need to all just, like, aggressively tweet Pharrell and just be like, what's good? Like, can you please get on the stage with Tim?
Here's the thing about Pharrell. It's not just Pharrell. It would have to be Pharrell and Chad. And, you know, Chad don't like the limelight. So if Chad is saying no, then Pharrell's probably going to follow suit and be like, no, I'm good too.
Yeah, but still, like, Pharrell's still been doing so much, and Chad has been in the background. Like, Chad ain't got to be there if he don't want to be there. He could be backstage for all it is. Like, just get up on the stage and just, like, and celebrate each other. Like, I would be so here for that. Like, it just makes more sense than Timberland and Swizz. Like, I get it, but it just makes more sense.
I feel you. I kind of don't want to see it unless Tim is bringing out Missy.
Right.
But you know what, though? It would be better if it was Timberland and Pharrell. Because that whole Virginia thing, that needs to happen.
Yep. Oh, my God. Like, can you imagine? Like, that love would be incredible.
I need the remaining members of Player. I need Gina Thompson. Okay. I need Total. Okay. I need SWV to come on back.
Come on back and do that same song.
Lil Mo.
Lil Mo.
Genuine. Magoo.
Yes, exactly. You know,
Nicole Ray,
all of them.
Like, they can do that by themselves.
Right.
It doesn't even have to be a battle. I just want to see the concert.
Right.
So that's supposed to go down on May 30th. Do we care about Bow Wow versus Soulja Boy?
No, not really.
I don't really care either.
That's just kind of forced, to be honest with you. Like, that's just kind of forced.
Does that make us old?
No, I don't think so. Because I'm, to be honest with you,
Little Bow Wow, you just don't know. I don't know that song. That's the only one I know from him.
But I don't know, like, if the younger generation would even be here for it.
Like, do they know? And then, you know, the Let Me Hold You, like.
Right.
And then Soulja Boy got.
Nobody's younger than this.
Like, I'm already tired. Like, do they each have a 20?
Right. I don't know.
They each have 20 songs.
I think Bow Wow probably is way closer than what Soulja Boy is. So,
see, I feel like Soulja Boy has more than Bow Wow does.
Really?
Yeah, because Soulja Boy had viral moments and dances, and Bow Wow had songs.
Yeah, but you gotta think about when he first came out. He was the little kid gimmick. You know what I mean? Like, so all of those songs from the beginning, even though I can't remember, as soon as you play them, you'll be like, oh, yeah. Because he was our Justin Bieber. He was our black version of Justin Bieber at that age. So everybody was on him.
Samaya, we are not playing your childhood. We just saying that your childhood was about maybe 10, 15 years after mine.
Wait.
That's all I'm saying. It's a gap. There is a gap. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, wait. So, Tamaya, can you please let me know Bow Wow's first song?
That was the one that I was singing. The Little Bow Wow. You just don't know.
That was the first song?
Yeah, that's the first one.
Oh, see, I don't even remember that.
That's all I remember from the song.
The first Bow Wow song that comes to me is I ain't never showed you that. You gonna...
I can't.
That's the first Bow Wow song that comes to mind.
Why was Bow Wow 12 for like 15 years, though?
I don't know. I don't know. That's because he's little.
I don't know. I think maybe Soulja Boy might take it, but we'll see. I don't know if either one of them has 20, but I think that Soulja Boy might get closer. So I'm not gonna watch, but I'll report back.
I'll probably tune in just to see how funny it is. Is that mean?
No, but you know what's funny though? That would be the one versus where somebody get to fight in on screen.
Right.
That would be the one where they just don't know how to act. Yeah. And that I would tune in for. That one I would definitely tune in for.
Right.
So anyway, you guys, let's get to it. We have a special guest that I personally am so happy to bring to the show. If you are unaware, she will be dropping a brand new song this Friday called Single Weather. The pre-orders have begun already, so please, after the show, go to your nearest DSP and pre-order the song. You can pre-save it on Spotify and all that good stuff. Shall we introduce her?
Let's do it.
Let's introduce her.
How quick fashion goes down the drain. Last week when you all was wearing pink, already for me red was old. The ultimate yellow brick is gold.
That's the new color, children. Hit it.
With this.
Now, where are we? There we go.
There we go. Welcome. Group chat.
Yes, there we go. Welcome to the show, my Lauren Ashley.
Hi, my Lenny.
Hello, Bo.
Today? I'm good, minus a few things.
Listen, we today is... What did we talk about last week? How we are geriatric millennials? I think we're feeling the geriatricness of it today.
I still don't like the term geriatric. What did we say? Evolve? What did we say? Evolve?
Elevated. Elevated millennials.
I like that better.
Right? Because geriatric sounds like we got like ace bands on.
But listen, the way I feel this week...
Yeah, well...
It's geriatric.
Yeah. Well, COVID will make you feel like that.
Yes.
Right.
Because I feel like I need to be in a whole nursing home. Hello? With somebody feeding me soup.
Hello? That's how when I say like I need to be coddled, I was like in the fetal position because it was that bad. I remember I was telling y'all, I was keeping y'all up to date with everything. I thought I was gonna get better. I felt like I was just getting worse and worse by the day. Yeah. Excuse me, people, if y'all hear me talking crazy. It's because I just came from the dentist, so I had to get filling.
It's okay.
My lips feel like it's like this.
She don't do drugs, y'all. She don't do the drugs.
Right.
Just went to the dentist. That's all.
Bite my tongue. That's what the problem is.
Yes. So outside of that, how are you? How has it been over this last year of the pandemic? And just, you know, what is going on in Lauren Ashley's world?
It's been a ride so far. I started a new job in December. So I'm working in IT now. Shout out to my job. I actually do like it. And just being a mom, I mean, that's the second job. And then becoming or developing or rebranding myself as an artist. So that has been what it's been this year, and I'm loving it.
Amen.
All right.
I would like you to give the fans a full, what's the testimonial about working with Natural City Music and why we're so great. I'm saying, no, I'm just playing. No, but like me and Lauren, we have been working for years, known each other for years, way back during my Block Stars days, and we've been cool ever since. And what's so funny is we hadn't done a lot of work, but we did do a lot of work, if that makes sense. Like we were always in the studio, whether it was at Block Stars or Track Fire, but we never got to work on anything for her specifically. And in, I guess, 2019, You know what it was? I think what it was that when you came to my show at my mom's house, mm-hmm. and you came late, but you still showed up and you still had a good time or whatever, like, that was the day that I was like, I gotta sign her.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Because it wasn't even like, because I knew like the music was gonna be good. I knew that the vocals is there. Like, I knew what to do. But I think what it was initiative. It was the fact that you showed up to support, because you know I'm very big on support. Mm-hmm. All three of us done had arguments about support.
Hello.
But you showed the support, and to me, that made you worthy of working.
Oh, yeah. And let me tell you about that day, too, because I remember. I remember seeing it, but I didn't know if it was open for everyone. Like, I thought it was exclusive. So I was like, oh, all right. And then I kept seeing it, and I asked somebody. I forgot who. I think it was Kate. I think it was.
No, you texted me. You texted me right before I got on the stage. Yep.
And I was like, yo, what time? And you was like, it starts at this time. I literally was in my living room. I was watching TV. I was like, whoop, got on my sneakers. God, I ain't even throw on no makeup. I was just like, yo, I'm out. Cause I was I wanted to be there. I was like, I have to be here. So I kept asking everybody, is it over? Everybody was like, it's over. I was
Cause
well, I'm still coming, cause I'm en route. I done made it halfway here. I'm coming.
So, I know that's right.
I mean, I was able to catch the tail end of it, but it was just such a good, it was a good vibe. You know what I'm saying? Good energy. Your mom's house is beautiful, by the way. The backyard was set up legit. Like, it was dope. So I was so glad I was there to partake in that, because it was really, really, it was really just amazing to me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, I appreciated it. I appreciate it. And then, like I said, I made the decision. I was like, we have to work. Like, no more waiting around. Let's do this for real. And we have some amazing music.
It's so funny because Nat used to talk to me all the time about, like, you know, who could help push the Natural City Sound, who would be perfect. And we would always bring up your name. Always. Yay. I used to be like, I think Lauren is the perfect example of how your music can be pushed out there. The sound could be pushed out there, and it could definitely elevate her in the same process. And listening to the body of work that you guys have sat and had fun doing, number one, you guys,
I don't even know how that happened.
Doing, because I don't even know how y'all finished every session, because
we laugh more than we record.
Yo, and I mean a breakout laugh of like, all right, start. And then we start, and then it'd be like this, all right, it's time to go.
Right. And it'll be over the dumbest thing.
Over the dumbest thing.
And then we will laugh for 25 minutes. And but somehow
I've been to a session. Trust me when I say I don't understand how they get anything done. But they did, and it's incredible.
Lenny, you caught up in the laughs too. So
right.
So but that's what you want to do. The whole purpose is to enjoy what you do and not have to feel like you're actually like working. You know what I'm saying? So for me, being able to have fun while doing what I love is like the best thing. And then when you work with somebody who is just as silly as you are, talented, you know, it's just, it makes it, it makes it easier.
And it didn't feel like work. It didn't. I don't think it ever felt like work for me.
Yeah.
And we got it done. So like we would get stuff done so quick that it would just be like, all right, so next song.
Okay. Like, you know, I hate mixing songs these days. And after the last project that I just did, I'm done. But mixing her stuff was just like, I want to do this.
Yeah.
You know, like, I want to make sure that she sounds amazing. I want to make sure that, you know, these other bitches out here are scared.
Right.
No shade.
No need to say anything.
Period.
I'm not talking about nobody specifically. We not doing
right.
I think for me, as an artist who's been trying to, yes, Elaine, laughter is a good medicine. I think for me, as an artist who's been trying to get out there and make it and establish myself as an artist, it's been hard. You know, I became a mom, so that kind of stopped things. And then it was like, well, do I continue or do I need to just focus on being a mom? And for me, it was finding that balance. And I think once I got a schedule, because with her, you know, with kids, no, y'all don't know, but when you have kids, you have to get a schedule going. You have to make sure people are there to watch your kids. So thank God for my mom. Thank God for my sister. Thank God for her grandmother. You know, it's just things like that. People who are there to help you, who want to see you succeed as well. So it would never be hard for me to just be like, can you watch it while I run to the studio? You know, sometimes I would have to, you know, ask ahead of time, but just to have that support with it, just like, go ahead, you're good. Like, she's here. So that's important for me. So it's been it's been great.
Yeah. I mean, we discussed this right before we made it official. And I came to you because, number one, I wanted to make sure that I wasn't promising anything that I couldn't give. Mm-hmm. And that your expectations of me were valid and were attainable, and that my expectations of you were valid and attainable. And the one thing that I wanted to make sure that we knew was, what are our goals?
Right.
You know, and I know I think it was last season, I got into it with one of my boys, Ron, about lowering our expectations about the business and being an artist or whatever. And he didn't like the fact that I kept saying to have realistic goals.
Absolutely.
But you have to have them, you know, especially in these days of everything being virtual, everything being copycat, everything being microwaved. It's like, okay, yeah, it's easy to get on with mediocrity.
Right.
But what about having a lasting talent and it being a slow burn? We're okay with that. You know, we don't have to do Beyonce numbers right out the gate. And if we do Beyonce numbers out the gate, that's great.
Right.
But we're going to do what we do. And do it within our realm of you know, what we do, our realm of excellence. And I think I think we've achieved that.
We have.
Yes. I cannot wait for y'all to hear it.
So Lauren, how do you feel right now, Lauren? Like, how do you feel about this body of work? Like,
how
excited is this process that you have, you know, decided to like, the time is right now
for
you
to present.
So what is that like? Tell us what that is.
It's exciting because I have never put out like a full body of work. Mm-hmm. I've always put out little songs. I would put out songs like at least every year or every 3 years is what it felt like. I tried to be consistent, but it's hard trying to find consistency. So to actually be able to put out a body of work that I am in love with, like, y'all don't know the excitement. You know, I have my, you know, my family, my sister is really it, who I like play like snippets for. And she's just like, every time I bring her something, she's like, oh, I like that. You know, it's always like, oh, what, you know, that shit, you know. So for me, it feels good when all of your songs are single worthy, you know? So, that's the best part for me. And I think it's just this is a monumental occasion. Is that how you say it? A monumental occasion for me, because I have been wanting to do this for so long. And to see, like, I'm going to be honest, like, to see all my friends, like, moving forward with it, being able to put out albums. And I'm just like, I'm happy for y'all, but when's it going to be my turn? You know what I'm saying? I want to be able to put out a body of work. I want people to, and then it was like, you got people constantly asking you, when you coming out with music? When you coming out with music? And it was just like, first of all, and I think a lot of people need to understand, when you are an artist, you have to make sure you find producers who you gel with. Cause it's like a relationship. Mm-hmm. Y'all have to be one with each other. And you have to be able to work creatively and cohesively. And for me, that's important. If there is nothing there.
Yeah.
It, clearly, I know you just like me. So that's the only reason why you're working with me. There's no you wanting to get to know me musically as an artist. Mm-hmm. You're trying to get to know me personally, and that's totally different.
Right.
Of course, you have to get to know me personally and to know how I am. And if you're a writer, that's cool. But if you're just a producer, you don't need to be getting to know me on that level.
Right.
So it was hard for me also to find that, because not to say that I'm the prettiest and attractive, most attractive person in the world, but as a woman who is attractive, it's hard to find people who are legitimately there to help you. They just there's people who just want, who have ulterior motives. So for me to be able to be with Nat, who I know genuinely is my friend, like genuinely loves me, genuinely wants to see me win. Working with you, Lenny, like having a team of people who genuinely want to see you win, that's the best. like the best. That's the best mix. The best mix.
And so, listen, I love pretty things, pretty people, but you know what's prettier than that? A check. So at this point, you can come on with it and try to flirt. You can show some skin, show a little leg and take it back. And okay. I'll be looking for that paycheck, though.
Okay.
So if that little leg is not in my Cash App or my Zelle.
Hello.
Okay.
I don't have anything for you. So trust me. And I got the stories to prove it. People have bought me everything. So everybody in this chat is like, we want to hear something. And so I figured we would give them a little snippet of the brand new song, Single Weather.
Okay.
And I want to give it its proper introduction, if that's okay with y'all.
Okay. Yeah,
come on with it.
Let's give it its proper. Amen.
Show me what you got. Show me what you got. I want to see what you got. I like what you got. Good job.
So, without further ado, here is y'all's first listen to Lauren Ashley's brand new single, Single Weather. Let me make sure I do this right. Hey, I did it right.
Mute us so we don't disturb anything.
Nigga, we grown.
We grown.
I ain't gotta tell you where I'm going. So don't.
So don't.
Call my phone and tell me what you want.
I thought we was gonna keep going.
No.
You know, the second verse is the part.
I'm posting over here.
They're liking it in the chat.
Yes.
They like single weather outside.
Single weather outside. We're gonna be in these streets. Okay.
Thank you, Denise.
We're gonna be in these streets. Oh, they are liking this. Hey,
oh, I'm y'all liking it.
Yes.
And hot fire.
Yes. Listen, so y'all have to go and pre-order this thing right now or after the show.
Or now.
Right. You can multitask. Amen.
Right.
But that is Single Weather, produced by Faro Jaro. He's a dynamite producer out of Atlanta. And that song was written by the three of us.
Yes.
Me, Lauren, and Lenny.
Yes, it
was. And it was super easy.
Super easy.
What's funny, I will say this though, what's funny about it is during the whole writing process of this project, we had been getting a lot of songs done, but we were trying to figure out how up to the line or over the line we wanted to go with certain subject matter.
Oh, yeah.
And we worked on this one song that you guys will hear.
Oh, my God.
And when I tell you, I ain't never written nothing like that before in my life.
Me neither.
Listen, but it's fire though.
Oh my God.
Like, I'm going to be honest. I played that song. I have a cousin who lives in Turkey. Mm. I sent her this song. She said, when is this going on Spotify? Because I need this ASAP. Then she was like, then she came at me the other day and she was like, Lauren, I just got to let you know that song, she was like, got me through some things.
See?
So, listen, instant pregnancy.
Listen.
If you're not careful.
Listen. Listen.
Don't have no Henny in your system.
Okay.
But what's funny is we did that song and then it was like, we both were like, why are we holding back?
Why are we holding back?
Let's be who we are. Yes. And not every song has to be romantic. Not every song has to be complaining about a bad relationship. And then sometimes we just want to have the sex.
Yeah.
So because we decided not to hold back, that's really how Single Weather came to be. It was like, all right.
Yeah.
Because I remember you came up with that concept of Single Weather. Like, I want to be out here. Like, I ain't tied down to nobody, so why?
Right. Yeah,
so.
And then when I wanted to be tied down, you wasn't trying to tie me down. Now that it's summertime.
Right, and the weather's getting more nice and easy. Like,
I'm out of here.
Okay. So, now, you can be in these streets. I will be in the house.
Well, number one, you got Rona, so you can't.
That's what I'm saying. I will be in the house because Rona sat my ass down.
Right. We dating Rona right now. That's what that is.
It will humble you.
It will. But you guys, Single Weather will drop on Friday on all platforms. Like I said, you can pre-order it today. It's available to pre-save on Spotify, all that good stuff. We have so much more coming for you. Like,
facts.
Like, we literally, like, and that was the reason why I got so mad that I was sick, because I had so many things planned on us doing and things that I needed to execute. And I'm like, damn it. But we still don't get it done. And I just want to know, like, how are you feeling so far? Like, this is about to happen. And it's been a long time coming, but how do you feel?
I'm ready. you know, I've been running and singing. And singing and running, so I can build this win, okay? Because I'm ready. I mean, I think for me, it's exciting to have the work done. I'm just excited. I'm ready. I can't even explain it. I'm just really happy and excited.
Amen. So, how do you feel about and one of the things that I also wanted to make sure that listeners got from you is that you are not just. Number one, know you're not just a pretty face, but also know you're not just trying to be out here riding the same coattails of other artists or doing the same sounds that other artists do. Like, I want people to know you as a singer.
Right.
How do you feel about that, you know, in regards to the current state of music?
You know, I think for me, it was always like, of course you want to create your own lane. And I think for me, because I have such I wouldn't say eclectic, but I have such a broad upbringing when it comes to music. Like, I study classical, I study folklore, jazz, pop, you know, all that stuff. So for me, I think for me, just having that background helped. Then I had a father who was a jazz musician, so he immersed me in music. I had a mom who sang too. She loved country music. I grew up on country music and classical music. So I didn't just grow up on your typical R&B, you know, and hip hop. I was very, it was
broad, all over the place. Yeah.
You know, so for me, I picked up on so many musical, my ear was just everywhere. So I had no choice but to pick up on everything. So for me, you'll hear a lot of that in my singing. I'm not typical because I feel like I have control. And for me, a lot of singers, I hate to say it, don't have control. And having control, and I will say what contributed to that was being able to go to performing arts high school. And being able to learn how to breathe properly, how to sustain notes, how to do it. You know, those type of things are what helped guide me into my vocals that I have now, because I could have been a great church singer like most people are. Like, you go to church, learn how to sing in church. I didn't learn how to sing in church. That wasn't my first place. For me, I learned how to sing from my dad. I learned how to sing by hearing what he played and listening to what he did. Mm-hmm. That's how I learned. So for me, I just want to make, I want to make sure that I am bringing myself. I'm just trying to do it in a way where it's catchy. It's a vibe. It's me. You know what I'm saying? It's me. And I'm a, I feel like I'm a vibe.
You know? You are.
You're yes. Like, alive.
You are.
So for me, it was just making sure I bring my I bring that to my music. So right. You feel that, you know, it's not right. Gimmicky. It's not corny. I mean, at least not to us. But, you know, it's not gimmicky. It's just me being me. I'm not trying. And I think that's for me. That's why I didn't listen to a lot of other people's music or a lot of other artists, because once you listen to that, you start to take that and you start putting it into your music. I try not to listen to any new music. People will be like, you know this artist? No, I don't. Did you hear this song? No, I didn't. Why? Because right now I'm not trying to listen to that, because then it's going to taint me.
Yeah.
So I have to stay focused on what I need to focus on, and that's me. And whether it's old school, whether I'm still doing this type of music or not, it's what I know. Right. And can bring some of those elements into it, then yeah, I'll do that. But I'm not, I think that's what people are doing now. They're trying to compete with what's out there. And for me, if you're a singer, you need to just sing, you know, just find ways in doing it that are good for you. And then you just have to, you also just have to listen to your audience as well. Right. Keeping it true. Like, you just have to really be true to yourself. So if you, if you do that, then I think you'll win, because that's how you'll get the, your true fans or your true supporters.
Right.
Yourself.
Right.
Amen. All right, come on here preaching.
Okay. I think that's really important, especially for any artist that's in here too as well. When you're in the middle of creating, don't be out here listening to so much material.
Nope. Yeah.
Because you're going to get, you know, inspired by that, to where you might start to compare yourself or put your own creativity in a box, trying to meet a standard that somebody else is in,
right,
necessarily yours. So I think that that is like super wise for any artist that's in here, is to make sure that it's organically you, and you're pulling from things that you love, the things that bring your voice more out, that bring out more color in yourself, you know, and sometimes that just takes shutting off every other influence.
Everything. Yo, you know what I listen to?
Your own resource. Yep.
I listen to a lot of like the music that I have on my phone is all from like 2017, 18. I think I would put like slowly put newer songs, but it still wasn't like nothing up. And I think that's why people used to be like, you always play the same songs. Why you got old songs over here? And I'm like, I don't understand my reasoning. I don't have newer songs because I'm not trying to, like, I don't want to interfere with what I'm trying to do. Right. I have to stay focused and remain focused on what I'm trying to do. And if I get any type of inspiration from that, I know I'm probably go there musically, and I don't want to go there. Mm-hmm. I don't want somebody to be like, oh, you took that or you took this. No, if anything, I want them to say they took that from me. I would rather be the one they took it from than me taking it from them.
Yeah.
That's what I'm just going to say. I'll put it that way. I want to be the inspiration for somebody else to take something.
Yeah.
This next comment is going to make us laugh.
Of course, Mondo would say that.
Of course. Of course he comes in to say that. But I will say this, Mondo. Technically, the project is still open. So if you got something... you know, we would like to have a Grammy Award winning producer on the album.
Okay.
Hello.
We don't mind that. We do not mind that at all.
Not at all.
I will say that what's interesting about what Lauren has brought to the table is she's already been putting in the work in. Like, it's been a journey, but she has already connected with producers. I only produced what, 1.5 songs on the project?
Really?
I think so.
Yeah. 1.5 songs. And everything else was either producers that you brought or producers that I found. But we wrote everything together, but most of this production is not me. Yeah. And it was because she already came with some really dope connections. Her best friend Corey produced several of the songs. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And there's some other people that's on here. I'm not gonna name them all because I don't know all the names right off the bat. But
Joel.
it's a really dope collection of production for this project that I think it doesn't just, you know, showcase who she is as a singer, but also who she is as a writer, who she is as a vocal arranger. Mm-hmm. Like, this had to be the easiest project I've ever worked on.
Yeah.
This was like easier than working on my own stuff. Like, because she doesn't fight me. And if a note is wrong, she'll let me know. Right. And, you know, and if it's not comfortable for her, she'll say it's not comfortable. Or if she really wants to get something. Yeah, but if she really wants to get something, then she'll get it. Like, she'll do the work to get it. Yeah. But this was so easy. Like, and it was fun.
It was fun.
Yes. Like,
and what I will say now about you, you pushed me. You know what I'm saying? You pushed me to do things I probably wouldn't have done. I would have been like, that's too high. I'm not doing it. But, and I think I did say that at one point, like, I'm not. And you was like, yes, you are. Come on, let's do it. And I was like, all right. I breathed and I did it, you know. But even with runs, I think that's why I really wanted to work with Nat, because I know, I mean, I know I can do runs, but sometimes you get used to doing the same ones all the time, or you get comfortable. And I wanted to step out that box and be challenged. And that challenged me in a lot of ways. And for me, that's what you want to be with someone who's going to challenge you and push you. Right. And Nat did that for me. Like, he did that. And it'd be times where I was like, I can't do that run. I can't do that. And then, of course, I would probably put a little bit of me in it. But at the end of the day, it was something I probably would have never thought to do. Mm-hmm. So thank you for pushing me to somewhere I would have never gone, and getting me out of my comfort. Because to be a musician, to be a singer, you got to get out your comfort zone. So thank you for that.
Yes. And thank you for allowing me to push you. Working on this project.
Yeah.
Working on this project it's been something that I've wanted to do for a very long time, because I know that I could put out music for myself. I know how it's going to sound. I know what to do to put it out and all that kind of stuff. But I've always wanted to do it for someone else. That is my lifelong dream. I've never really wanted to be in the spotlight. So I've always been trying to find that person who could carry the sound. And I know I've worked with Lenny. I've worked with Steve Lavelle. I've worked with a ton of different people, but there haven't been many people that were like, it clicked, you know? And it was like, oh, this is the thing. This is it right here. Yeah. And that's what this is. This is the thing. And when y'all hear the thing,
yes.
And one more thing I have to add to this is just to piggyback on what you said too, Lauren. This is, the body of work is already such a sound in itself. Like, because you guys were not really influenced by other things of what's going on currently, it was true to everything that you are, you know what I mean? Like, Nat really made sure to pull out certain things, and you came with concepts, like, because Nat would call me and be like, this, she done came in here with this concept. So you came with the concepts, you knew what you wanted. Even if you couldn't articulate it all the way, you knew what you, you had a base element, you know what I mean? And the way you guys were able to work and really create a sound, like, this itself, I think that's what's so special about it. It doesn't sound like anybody else. It really doesn't. And that's the beauty of it. And I think people are, that's what's really going to help people really connect to it. And that's what's going to make you that it girl, like, seriously, because this body of work is beautiful. Y'all really put in the time, the hours, the laughs, the love, the focus, the, you know, being particular, you know what I mean?
Right.
You know, and even when it came down to mixing, like, Nat would be like, yeah, Nat, this is just a rough mix. And then he would be like, I'm mixing it again. Like, you know what I mean? Like, just to be that particular, to make sure that it was the best that it possibly could be. I'm telling you, a lot of artists don't put that much effort into it. And I think that that's really going to show. And when people finally get a chance to hear the rest of this amazing body of work, they're going to be taken for such a ride.
And you deserve to win.
Yeah,
you deserve to win. Really, you've been waiting. You've been grinding. I know you have been patient. And honestly, all of that is about to pay off. I know on Sunday, when you did the living room NJ, you mentioned that the project's coming out next month. We ain't really make that decision yet. But
I'm busy.
But it's going. we're going to still be dropping things over the summer, because what we don't want is for the project to come out and y'all just forget about it. This needs to grow with you and your listeners. It has to grow with the new fans. I want people to hear this music and be like, what the entire fuck is this? And why have I not heard it before? Like, that's what I need to happen with this project, because it doesn't sound like anything that's been out. You're singing your face off. The production is immaculate. The mixing is great. The lyrics are amazing. Like, the concept, the artwork that we're going to be doing, the videos that we're going to be doing, like, I want people to know that this came from an indie artist on an indie label with damn near no budget. Okay. And it still can rival your biggest major artist. Yeah. So I'm excited. I know I'm selling it a lot, but I have to, since I'm the executive producer.
but and I will say me. That what, like, of course you want to stay relevant to what's happening as far as, you know, like, so Single Weather Outside, like, of course, everybody's been saying it. So it's like, all right, well, let's make it into a song. You know what I'm saying? Right, feel like Single Weather thought, you know, I'm be in these streets. You kept hearing that. Now I'm like, I just saw a video from, she's a comedian, but she had like the streets. It was like the streets calling or something like that. And I thought that was so crazy.
Yes.
That she just put this out yesterday. Wow. You know what I'm saying? So
People are watching.
And then it was too weird. It was like a man, it was like her boyfriend or some guy. And then she was like in the streets and you know, she had it like going like this. And then she like walked out to the streets. And I was just like, yo, that it's just, that lets you know that the song is where it should be because it's relevant to now. I wasn't going with what I was hearing, but I was going with what I was hearing as far as topics.
Yeah. Right. So. Right. And that's usually how it happens. It's organic. Like, oh, it's warm out. Okay. I'm going to be in these streets.
Yes. Right.
Let's actually be there. No problem. Yep. So let me see. I think that's all I got. I know after this episode, I'm getting directly in the bed.
Yes. Y'all need to rest.
Yes.
But are there any questions in the chat? Anybody that's watching either on Facebook or YouTube, you got any questions?
For Lauren, don't ask me no questions. I ain't got no breath. I've been talking. But is there anything that you would want to tell your listeners to look forward to the new music? Like, just anything that you want to leave them with?
Look forward to relatability. Look forward to vibe. And look forward to, what's the word I'm looking for?
Right notes.
Right notes. But I was also going to say, like, look forward to, dang it, you made me lose it.
I'm sorry.
I don't even know.
I'm sorry.
Just look forward to a good body of work, a great body of work.
Yes. Like, with all the feels.
With all the feels. You got everything you can think of on there from, and everything you either been through, you've gone through, or going through now. Like, there's something for everyone. Not just females. They don't just cater to females. It caters to everybody. And that's what I really want it to be about. It being able to, like, men being able to say, yo, I've been through that, or yo, I can feel that. You know, not just females, but men too. Because, you know, I care about y'all.
Yes. Definitely. Amen. Amen. So, Lauren, I appreciate you for coming on. This has been a week of weeks for all of us, but we made it through. We pushed it on through. If you're in the room, please go and pre-order Single Weather today. It is out. The link is right here on the bottom.
On the bottom.
And that's it. Oh, and when it comes out, even if you don't want to pre-order it, please go get it anyway. And then play it forever.
Yeah.
Go to sleep with it playing. Okay. We want to get numbers. Numbers don't matter, but it would be fun. It would be nice to see it.
It would be nice.
So, and if you are a fan of Lauren, tell a friend. Please, please, please tell a friend. If you're a fan of ours, tell a friend, because we're all working with her. So if she wins, we win. That means y'all win. And like, it's,
and everybody wins.
Everybody wins. Y'all get some good music and we get a coin. Amen.
That's it. Amen.
So, but that's basically it, Lauren. Thank you so much for coming on to the show.
Yes, thank y'all for having me. See,
we really wanted to do this. We really wanted to do this in person, but you know, I got the
Like, we probably wouldn't have got nowhere.
No.
Right. It would have been laughing. And
it would have been a hot mess.
It would have been a hot mess. But this is good that it happened.
Yes. Right. Yes. And it was still fun. So
right, it was still right, fun.
Right. So that's basically it. Tell everybody where they can follow you.
Y'all can follow me at IAML_AYE. That's IAM.
Open your eyes there on the screen. Look at it.
Oh, Lord.
Look at it. It's on the screen. See? I put it up just in case.
Y'all can follow me there. You can follow me on Facebook. We just got a page going, or the page was there.
Yes.
I probably just didn't pay attention to it.
No, it's new. It's okay.
All right. Yes. what is that one?
I'll tell you later, but it's on Facebook.
Together, y'all, but yes.
Oh, it's Lauren Ashley NCM.
Yes, that's right. Lauren Ashley NCM. I was like, I know it's something. Yes. Right. So follow me on Facebook. We're getting the page together. So if you don't see a lot of things on it, don't worry. We're building it. We're creating it. You're just be along for the ride. That's all.
Exactly. Right. And that's what we want. Right. So rest up, Lauren. Make sure your lip is good. And,
it's better. It's not even, it went down.
Okay, perfect. Amen.
Yes, I'm good.
Tell Peyton we said hi.
Yes.
I was hoping she was going to make a cameo. That would have been cute.
No, I told her, say hello. I said, you know that it's all right. Y'all know I'm real when it comes to Peyton.
Right.
Y'all done heard me on the phone many times.
Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, God. Wait, I almost laughed and coughed up the whole lung.
Right.
Oh, my God. Okay. See, this is why we can't. Yeah. All right. Good night, Lauren. We love you. And we will see you very soon.
All right. Bye, all guys. Right.
Oh, my goodness. That was too funny. Okay. We both out here coughing like two grown old men.
Old men. Okay. Listen.
Oh, my goodness. So I guess.
May 28th.
Yes. May 28th. The single drops, you guys. We're going to wrap this up because I can't. Okay. All right, let's wrap it up.
You want to keep warm when you're feeling chilled, but you don't want to raise your heating bill. Now, there's the Snuggie, the blanket that has sleeves.
Okay.
You good?
That laugh just took everything out of me.
I know,
This was not as bad as last week. Last week I was okay. My throat was on fire last week,
same.
Now it's just like my breathing stops right here.
Yeah.
It doesn't go back down to the lungs.
Yeah.
But I can't wait for you guys to hear the song in full. We did our good writing. We did our good singing. Mm-hmm. Lauren is that artist that you definitely want to pay attention to.
Yeah.
That's all I got to say. And if you miss out, then you miss because you probably just hate it.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
So,
exactly.
Next week, you guys, is our season finale.
Season finale.
I don't know what God has in store. We were supposed to be together. We was going to do a whole concert.
Yeah, we were. We don't know where that's going to stand just yet.
Like,
why am I doing the Obama thing?
We were really trying to do like a whole concert for y'all because we haven't sung in so long. I can still sing, but what I can't do is breathe. And what we're not going to do is be on the interweb, on Beyonce's interweb, getting wrong notes out of breath.
Right.
So,
The internet is forever.
But we will figure out something special to do for you guys as long as we are still okay. We'll still probably be virtual just to be safe because next Tuesday is the last day of my quarantine. So I'll still be here in the house. He'll still be in his place. So we'll figure it out.
Yeah.
I don't know what we're going to do. We might do like a nice little recap. Maybe if I got vocals by then, I could give y'all a little snippet of something.
Right.
If you got vocals by then, maybe you give them a little snippet of something.
Listen, we're going to try to do what we can do.
Maybe I'll just twerk.
Right. It could be 20 minutes of us twerking. How about that? You know,
I feel like y'all really want to see that. And so we may have to make that happen.
See that too, you know what I mean? So, you know.
I know this season has been a lot of growth. It's been a lot of elevating the platform. Thank God for StreamYard with us being able to do this virtually and it's still looking so good. Mm-hmm. I know we were a little slow rolling on the clips from last week, but we were both bedridden. So you'll get clips eventually. But thank you for sticking with us this season. It's been really, really fun. You guys have been amazing in the chats. You've been amazing online and supporting us. And we hope to be even bigger and better for you guys next season. That's it. That's all I got. Ain't got no more.
Ain't got no more.
Please tune in. Y'all have an
amazing night. And make sure you tune in next week, 7 p.m. on the YouTube. Yes.
On the YouTube and on the Facebooks.
And on the Facebooks.
Okay.
Yeah, and we're going to bring you this season finale.
Amen.
Yes.
Oh, you know what we're going to do? We can do our, we could do like a halfway point wrap up of everything we've been listening to and watching. And just kind of keeping everybody up to date with that, because we've been watching a lot. There's been a lot to listen to. There's been a lot to watch on TV and movies and stuff. And I think it'll be good for us to just address everybody and, you know, talk about us going on break. Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's it, y'all. We love y'all for watching. Again, tune in next week. And that's it. I'm still talking a lot. And I need to go to bed.
I know. Good night.
I'm just trying to be a good host. Good night, y'all. Peace.